So how does dimension work? In short, it works just like an ordinary smoke detector. And a normal detector, a normal optical smoke detector, has an infrared light source. That light source is normally fired across a chamber in an ordinary detector, and a light receiver that picks up that light when it's scattered by smoke. Dimension works just the same. We have an infrared light source. The difference is it's shining out of a window outside the chamber. And then just in the small area in front of the detector, if there's smoke present there, it will scatter light back towards a receiver that's looking through a separate window. So in some ways, it's just like a normal detector. It uses infrared light scattering. But the difference is it's happening in the outside world. So the infrared light receiver can see everything else that's going on, like daylight, like artificial lighting in the room, like insects moving around in front of it. So we have to put in extra sensors and extra intelligence to make sure we can still detect the smoke and not be influenced by these other factors. Those are the real challenges with developing dimension, overcoming those additional problems such as dust, insects, objects in the room, and still being able to detect that tiny amount of light that gets scattered by smoke from the emitter back to that infrared light receiver. So we had to put in additional sensors. So additional optical sensors are built in, and they can detect if there's someone putting their fingers in front of the detector, if there's insects flying around in front of the detector. And we use a bit of intelligence to combine the signals from these multiple optical sensors and determine if what we're seeing is smoke from a fire or some other kind of nuisance source. So what do we do if we detect a nuisance? It depends on the type of the nuisance. So if we measure dust on the window, we can signal that back to the panel as a dirt reading, or if the dirt level is too high, as a trouble signal. And then the user can take action. In the case of dirt, they can go back with a cloth and give it a wipe and update the reading and get a clean signal. If it's something more malicious, like someone's covered up the detector to try and prevent it detecting smoke, we can signal a fault signal back to the panel. And then the user can take appropriate action then, depending on how they want to set up their device and their panel. So in a nutshell, that's how dimension works.